A little bit shaky because it's very high.
So yesterday I left Plitvice National Park late in the evening and drove to Zadar city in Croatia. I arrived to Zadar around 9 p.m. and I was a little beat from all the walking. So I got online and I basically booked the first reasonably priced hotel that I can find near the old city of Zadar. Now let me tell you why Zadar is a great place to visit. In my opinion, the location of Zadar is a perfect starting point in order to visit some of the most interesting places in Croatia. Both Plitvice Lakes and Krka are less than 90 minutes off a drive and there are multiple bus tours that take visitors to both locations. On top of all that, Zadar itself has so much to offer. Zadar is the oldest continuously inhabited city in Croatia. Due to its rich history and vibrant present, Zadar is now one of the most popular Croatian tourist destinations. It is named Entertainment Center of the Adriatic by the Times magazine. It is also very well connected with Italy and most of the cruise lines in the Mediterranean Sea. So if all roads lead to Rome and Italy, all the cruise lines lead to Zadar in Croatia. I found all the charm of Zadar behind the old city wall. So I basically spent the entire day in the old city and I still feel that I have not seen everything. So if that is something that you plan on doing, make sure you wear some comfortable non-slippery shoes. The cobblestones are perfectly polished and can be very slippery. The old city offers a perfect balance between modern and traditional. You can go from this historic food market all the way to high-end fashion shops, and along the way you can find dozens of amazing restaurants and coffee shops. You can even bring your beach towels, go for a swim, and sunbathe all day. I started my visit of the old city by climbing up 180 stairs to the top of the Cathedral of St. Anastasia. The Tower of St. Anastasia dominates Zadar's skyline. You cannot miss it, especially as you approach the city from the sea. This tower dates back to the 12th century and stands approximately 180 feet tall. If you manage to make it to the top, you will get to enjoy some of the most stunning views of the city of Zadar. There is a fee of 15 kunas, which is about $2, but the views are totally worth it. You can stay up there as long as your heart desires. Just make sure you are not next to the bells when they go off. They will literally blow the ears off your head.
I made it.
After getting some amazing shots from the top of the bell tower, I headed down to the Church of St. Donatus. The Church of St. Donatus is considered Zadar's most important historical monument. It is more famous than the Cathedral of St. Anastasia. The Church of St. Donatus is a stunningly well-preserved 9th century church. In fact, it was built on top of an old Roman forum and makes use of many of its original design. The church is no longer used for any religious services. Nowadays, it is used for medieval musical concerts. There is also a media light show at night, which explains all the projectors inside. So if you happen to be staying in Zadar overnight, don't miss the show. I was also told by one of the locals that the acoustics inside this amazing structure are mind-blowing. It was time for a lunch break, and of course, I had to have some seafood. A short walk away from the bell tower and the Church of St. Donatus, you can find yourself at the center of the famous People's Square. It's believed that the square was developed as early as the 11th century. From medieval times until the present day, the square continues to be the center of urban life for locals. Throughout the square, you will find a range of elegant cafes with sprawling patios. While basking in the ambience, look to one side and you can see the city loggia, a 13th century administrative building still being used today but only for exhibitions. Across to the northern side of the square is the city guard tower. The clock on the tower hasn't stopped ticking since 1803. A few steps from People Square, you can find the Five Wells Square. I was not able to save the footage of the Five Wells due to a technical problem, but hopefully I can redeem myself by telling you a little about the history behind the Five Wells. Zadar's Five Wells Square is located in front of the Captain's Tower and the City Wall. They were built in the 16th century during the siege of the Ottoman Empire army and allowed Zadar to survive the Turkish attack. The wells no longer provide drinking water, but they are a sight to be seen. Next to the wells are the historical Queen Yelena Madia Park and the Serene Park of Vladimir Nazora. Queen Yelena Madia Park was created on top of the city fortress by an Austrian commander named Franz Ludwig von Velden. Governor von Velden loved nature. So during his time in Zadar, he collected plants and turned the park into a lush botanical garden. Unfortunately, during World War II, much of the park was destroyed. Only some trees survived, but the park was gradually revived to become the marvel that is today. I spent the rest of my afternoon enjoying the serenity of this park before I leave the city of Zadar. My next destination is Split City. Make sure you stay tuned for my experience in Split. Until then, I thank you for watching. I will catch up with you in a few days.
I got some dried figs. These are just halfway dried.